My name is Chris Pires, and I'm professor and head of department of soil and crop sciences at Colorado State University. And we're out here this morning in a wonderful field of mostly the genus Brassica. Brassica is a genus in the mustard or cabbage family, the Brassicaceae, and includes about 30 species of wild and domesticated plants, including many hybrids and cultivars. The genus Brassica is native to Western Europe, particularly around the Mediterranean. It has spread throughout Asia, and it since then has been cultivated or become a weed throughout all of the Americas and pretty much all over the planet except for Antarctica. Six species of Brassica have been studied intensively because they are agronomically very interesting. These include the diploids Brassica rapa, Brassica oleracea, and Brassica nigra. And those three species have been hybridized and then have their genomes doubled in a process called polyploidy to make Brassica napus, Brassica carinata, and Brassica gentia. These six species are described as the triangle of U, named after a cytogeneticist who discovered that you could artificially hybridize them and then double their chromosomes to make the other three species. Almost all parts of the plant in Brassica have been domesticated, including roots, in the case of Swedes and turnips, stems, in the case of kohlrabi, leaves, in the case of cabbage, collard greens, and kales, flowers, we know from the grocery store, broccoli, cauliflower, Romanesco broccoli, the buds of the plants from Brussels sprouts and cabbage, and finally the seeds of plants, including mustard seeds and rapeseed and canola oil. Brassica oleracea is often called the dog of the plant world. You know that dogs have many different forms, but did you know that cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, and kohlrabi were one species, Brassica oleracea, just like a dog? What's really interesting about Brassica oleracea, unlike many domesticated plants, all parts of the plant have been domesticated. Kohlrabi is the stem. Broccoli and cauliflower are inflorescences that have been domesticated. Brassica oleracea has also been domesticated for the leafy parts of the plant. For example, there are many forms of cabbages and collard greens and kales. The origins of Brassica oleracea have been a mystery for a long time, and there have been many theories of where they evolved from in terms of the wild relatives. One theory about where domesticated plants come from is the idea that where the greatest number of current wild species occurs is where the plants originated from. In the case of Brassica oleracea, most of the wild relatives are found in Sicily and in southern Italy. So for example, here we see a couple of species that are from Sicily. Another theory put forward by Darwin and others is that plants that look like a cultivated cabbage are where the plants came from. So if you go to the coast of England or the coast of France, you will find wild cabbages that live on the coast. Linguists have come up with a third theory by examining ancient texts in Greek and Latin. In 2021, our lab, in collaboration with a global group of investigators, used primarily DNA evidence as well as linguistic and other evidence to confirm the linguistic theory, which is that Brassica oleracea's current wild relative that exists today, we believe, is Brassica cretica, which is growing right here. These are found in Greece, Crete, and the other Aegean islands. Brassica rapa has been domesticated into many different morphotypes. Humans have selected for the roots, the leaves, the flowers, as well as the seeds. The root types of Brassica rapa include primarily turnips. Edible turnips were probably first domesticated into Europe, and then later were domesticated and moved into China and Japan. Oilseed forms of Brassica rapa have been domesticated both in the Mediterranean, thinking of field mustard, and the sarsens, as well as in India and further east. Brassica rapa has been domesticated into many types of leafy vegetables. Leafy Brassica rapas include bok choy, Chinese cabbage, and other forms in Asia. The geographic origins of Brassica rapa have been difficult to determine because they've been domesticated into so many different forms. In addition, some of the domesticated species have gone feral, meaning that they have returned back into their native habitats or adjacent habitats and have now assumed a more wild-like state. The most recent genetic studies of Brassica rapa indicate that it probably originated 4,000 to 6,000 years ago in the Hindu Kush area of Central Asia. Brassica napus is another species in the genus Brassica, thought to be a hybrid between Brassica oleracea and Brassica rapa. Brassica napus includes three different morphotypes: Siberian kale, where we eat the leafy parts, rutabaga, where we have the underground stem, and then rapeseeds, or the oil seeds. Canola is a type of rapeseed which has been bred for low uric acid and low glucosinolates. Rapeseed is primarily grown in two forms: a winter form and a spring form. The winter forms are primarily grown in Europe and Asia, primarily because of their vernalization requirement. Spring rapeseed is cultivated in Canada, Northern Europe, and Australia. Brassica napus was originally domesticated in Europe and then spread into India, Asia, and is now grown pretty much worldwide. One of the mysteries about the origins of Brassica napus is whether or not it originated once or multiple times from the hybridization of Brassica rapa and Brassica oleracea. If one looks at genetic markers from the chloroplast, one may think that Brassica napus originated multiple times. However, it could be true that Brassica napus evolved once and then had many back crosses or introgression events to wild relatives.